Hello and welcome to another episode of Crossroads Rebuild. My name is Steven and this is my 2007 Ford Fusion, my first Copart salvage car rebuild project. But this is not what we're here to talk about today. We're here to talk about this, my next project. This is my 2006 BMW E90 3 Series, the 330xi. I picked up this 2006 BMW 330xi, also known to those in the BMW community as the all-wheel drive version of the E90 3 Series, in Dayton, Ohio. You know that I took you along for a tour of the Indianapolis Copart location a few weeks ago, and I actually went back the week after that. I've looked at a lot of cars there, I've bid on a lot of cars there, but in Indiana, I can't purchase a salvage car or a clean title car at auction without a broker. Because I have to use a broker in Indiana, my budget has to be a lot lower so that I can compensate for the brokerage fees. So even though I've bid on quite a few cars here in Indiana, I've lost those auctions just simply because they're worth more than I can bid with the brokerage fees at this time. So I bought this car, again sight unseen, from the Dayton location, and I think I have a real winner here. We'll talk about the damage in just a minute, but let's talk about how good this car is first. This 330xi would be considered high mileage. It has about 180,000 miles on it, but the car does not look like it has 180,000 miles on it. Inside and out, this car has been impeccably maintained. It's clean, there's almost no wear, the body is free of dents and dings, except for the damage from the accident. Again, we'll talk about that in a minute. The paint is still pretty glossy. The original owner put a clear bra plastic film on most of the front of this car. I'll try to show you a close-up of that. The clear bra film is actually in kind of poor shape from age, but it's done a great job of protecting the front of this car. It's on the bumper, it's on the hood, the fenders, it's on the mirrors, the door handles, it goes up the A-pillars. They were really doing everything in their power to take care of this car. In fact, there's a window sticker on the driver's side of the windshield that's a parking permit for a hospital there in Ohio where this car is from. And so my assumption is this car probably belonged to a doctor. They probably used it for their commute back and forth to work, and it looks like they took really, really good care of it. This car is in great shape. So now let's talk about the accident damage. The car was hit here in the passenger side rear door and wheel area. Obviously from the angle of the wheel, the suspension was tweaked. Haven't taken the wheel off to look exactly at what's broken or bent. But I looked at it on the trailer and I actually couldn't see what was broken. On the trailer, to be honest with you, everything I could see looked really good still. So I'm hoping there's not a ton of damage, but we'll find that out once we get into the car. As far as the body goes, that door is going to have to be replaced completely. I've already been looking. Those doors can be replaced for a few hundred dollars. Hopefully I can find one of the same body color, so maybe I can avoid paint. So the door has to go, and then the frame is going to have to be pulled. It did get into this lower, I don't know if you call it the rocker panel or the rear quarter area, but I have a friend who has a frame shop. I'm going to take it to him and let him Give me a quote. I've already shown him pictures and he's confident that it can be fixed. And then there's obviously going to be a little bit of body work here in this rear fender. Some of this will be able to be buffed out. Like there's a little bit of scuffing here on the bumper. That'll buff out. And there'll probably be some body filler and paint on this rear fender. And unfortunately, this door doesn't open. So that'll be a project in and of itself, just to get the door open so we can get it off. Probably going to have to cut it open from the outside in order to get the mechanism freed so we can get the door opened. I want to save all of the interior panels because they are in pristine condition. So the damage looks ugly, but as you saw in the video of me backing off the trailer, even though this looks bad, the car actually still can move under its own power. You wouldn't want to drive it far that way, but it can be moved under its own power. So I'm hopeful that there's nothing too serious underneath there. My first project is going to be going ahead and trying to fix the suspension so that I can actually drive the thing, and then we'll get it over to my buddy and let him start working on straightening all the bent stuff here. So as you can see, my new little BMW has a totally different type of damage than the Fusion. Fusion was all front end damage. It's a much simpler car than the BMW, but it was all front end damage, all bolt-on, bolt-off stuff, and the Fusion has been a great car to learn on. The BMW is totally different type of damage. This one has suspension damage. It has frame damage, damage to the door. So this is a totally different type of damage. Why did I buy this car? Well, first of all, this car was just too nice to pass up, in my opinion. The car is in such fantastic condition. I hope that comes across in the video. But the second reason I wanted this car and the Fusion is because I'm learning different aspects of the rebuilding process. As you know, the Fusion is my first rebuild project. This is my second. And ultimately, I'll probably sell both of these cars. Although I'll tell you this, I like this BMW so much, I might keep it for a little while and just enjoy driving it for a minute. But I'm buying these cars so I can learn different aspects of rebuilding. And long term, even though I'll build rebuild cars as a hobby, and even though I may flip a few to bring in a little bit of profit, my ultimate goal is honestly to rebuild cars that I want to keep. I have a few bucket list cars that I really, really would like to have and keep for good. And the most affordable way to get those cars, honestly, is to buy a wrecked one and rebuild it. That's not for everybody. A lot of people would probably just rather save up their money and buy a clean title car that's never had an accident. But I find a lot of fun and enjoyment out of the rebuild process. There's something just intangible about being able to say, I worked on this. It went from this broken thing to this thing that now looks fantastic. And so that is something that I enjoy. I'm looking forward to one day being able to buy some of these bucket list cars and rebuilding them and then being able to enjoy them on a long-term basis. One of my bucket list cars actually is the M5 from about the 2005 to 2008 or 9 era. That is my favorite. Naturally aspirated V10, 507 horsepower, supercar wearing sedan clothing. I love the M5 of that era, and I would love to buy one of those someday and rebuild it. So I'll work up to that, as well as a few other cars that I'd really like to have. But for now, I've got these that I'm learning to build or to rebuild with. So tell me in the comments what you think about my new BMW project. Do you think I've maybe bit off more than I can chew, or maybe it's not worth saving? Or do you think I got a great deal? By the way, how much did I pay for this car? I got it for $1,300, $1,300 from Copart in Dayton. So did I get a great deal? What do you think? I'm looking forward to the rebuild project one way or the other. I'm gonna have fun doing it, and you can stay tuned for the episodes following the rebuild of the BMW. Now, in the next episode, we'll be back to the Fusion. The next thing I need to do is bolt on the front of the car, make sure all my panels line up well, fix a few little dings in the bumper, and then get everything, the bumper too. I need to fix a few little dings in the hood and the bumper, then get it all painted, bolt it back on, final assembly, and hopefully here soon, I'll be able to have the Fusion completely done and ready for sale, and I can concentrate all my efforts on the BMW. So stay tuned for future episodes on finishing up the Fusion and starting the rebuild project on the BMW. Thank you for watching. If this is your first time coming to the Crossroads Rebuild YouTube channel and this is the first episode that you're watching, why don't you go ahead and subscribe and then click that bell notification icon so that you can be notified each time that I upload a new video. Thank you for watching and we'll catch you in the next episode.